When you're sitting alone with a god awful film, the rage is
show us your tips and I'll tell
you.
Just normal men. Just innocent men.
The worst of the worst. We watch these things so you don't have to. The worst of the worst.
Hello, I'm Ryan.
Hello, I'm Sam.
I'm Cameron.
And I'm Jamie. And today we've got another special guest. It's Louis.
Hello.
I'm wrecking the joint already.
You've just dropped a coaster.
And this is Dr. Utopia.
This is all the way from Edinburgh to be.
I know, he actually took a trek. Yeah. It's been a long time coming.
We've been talking about this for a while.
It's my favourite Doctor episode of the song.
Is it?
Yep.
Oh no. Here he is.
But you know what? The music here kind of fucks.
The music in the whole episode. But
yeah. Have you seen the edit where someone's done the Torchwood finale?
Yeah, right into this.
It's quite cool.
I remember watching, when I did my Torchwood watch through for the first time, because obviously when it came out I was way too young, but watching it through for the first time with Torchwood, and I was like, oh my god, it's perfect.
You can see him running towards in the final shot.
You can, yeah.
It's like the overhead of it.
Season 1 is unhinged.
I have no idea where my box is.
Check out Unhinged on the Northern
Mail. Speaking of Unhinged, how is Blood reading it?
Because he's Gallifreying.
Yeah.
I'm not really funny. That's not words.
No, it's not.
It's Gallifreyan.
Are you trying to say that? Or would you say that Mandarin isn't words just because it's a different alphabet?
No, it is words.
Jack should have been on the edge of the TARDIS.
That's what I just said.
To be fair, see that monster cabinet guy? That's why I smashed
it up.
Just eating
my ass. This is another Graham Harper banger.
Oh, Graham Harper's so fucking good.
Yeah.
He's just, again. There's no zero, it's all just 11.
Yeah. It's just an odd beat.
He is.
Oh! Can I live with you? But he's great.
But wasted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And fuck this bitch.
Do you know she's the same actress that's the fortune teller in Turn Left?
Yeah.
What will you be?
Smash.
100%.
What? It's been a while, but could you smash? Could you fuck that?
Oh, yeah. What is that? What is she? Like a beetle?
Bug.
The Beatles have holes
somewhere. I'm sure.
For the eggs.
Yeah. I've not listened to any of it, but I've heard his Big Finish stuff is.
I've heard a bit of it.
He's been turned into like the War Master. This one. I'm like, that's a nifty thing.
He gets his own laser screwdriver.
John Hart's deed, so no.
No, but like, those two are the war. Regeneration.
Yes.
It's quite a nice, nifty thing to have.
Mm-hmm. I'd laugh if like he's just so, because he's human, he just genuinely has a heart attack. Imagine that, but he just
has a stroke.
There and then. I love the music here when they come out and it's the Torchwood little thing.
They do that so many times.
Yeah.
It's literally just looking at his
Jack's little theme.
Every single time it happens in an episode, it's just peak.
Is that
your musical fun fact?
No.
No.
I can't wait. I think it's next episode.
Oh god.
Is that a sign?
This is fucking garbs!
does that count as a Torchwood reference?
Yes.
It's a Torchwood reference. Do you know what would it ask? I think I said this a few episodes ago. What would have been good if he was just a burning skeleton?
For fuck's sake.
Burned up in the time vortex.
Well, he did that in Torchwood.
And he just goes,
I love this. He's just a funny little man.
Why does he always do that? Why does he always wake up so dramatically?
I think it's very in character for him to do that.
The one time they don't do it is in Day 4, Children of Air.
I mean, after Yanto's kicked, and he goes,
That would be the hilarious thing.
Just after his lovers died.
Or do you like, you know, the Tom Cruise in The Mummy where he like is in the body bag and he's like, we've got two universes, two sex offenders.
Oh no!
Allegedly.
They should do a spin-off about the Time Agency. That would be a great idea.
And bring back James Marsters.
Yeah, that would be a cool idea for a spin-off.
My cock's bigger.
My cock's bigger than yours.
Yeah.
Who do you think has a bigger cock, Captain Jack or the Doctor?
Depends on which regeneration, because Captain Jack was swinging.
Have you ever seen the Doctor?
Speaking of how he's packing that meat.
That's what I mean, according to Joe.
Have you ever seen the Doctor and Sex in the same room? That's what I thought.
Jodie's packing that schmeat.
She is.
Hell yeah.
According to Georgia Tennant, he carries a 10-incher.
Yep.
Yeah, she calls him David 10-inch.
I love her tweets so much. They're just gold.
Just simply.
This bit was always so random to me.
Well, that's Chan Tho's. Yeah, we.
Is it?
Yeah, it's her dad.
That's her gaff.
Yeah, it's her gaff.
Yeah, my
gaff.
Yeah, my fucking deal gun.
The music though. I always maintained that I preferred it when Jack got out his gun because he absolutely did shoot someone in the face. He was great.
Yeah.
I've got the image of him with the gun to his side getting the shotgun out. Reflected. Why are they not just executing him?
Because life is so precious.
Ah, fuck it.
At the end of the universe.
Nah.
I like the idea though. The
you think they get good head?
It's like a metallic, like, man. Do they ever explain, like, what the fuck they are?
No.
It's such a classic Who thing, like, they just turn up in a random environment, there's these weird people with makeup on going, chasing you about.
To be fair, I kind of like that.
Yeah.
I like his stuff, I like his big poop, like, puffy shirt.
It was supposed to be a homage to William Hartnell.
Oh,
it's like a subtle wee.
But you can tell he won a competition because he's Scottish and he can cast Scottish.
Yeah,
that is so true.
That's very true.
Yeah, but they made the put on in the accent.
Is this not the corridor from that is in series 4 like all the time,
yeah.
The one at the bottom of the adipose thing, I think it's been just done up.
It's also the episode of Dalek.
It's that yes,
big
it's the Van Staten.
Yeah, it's just the corridor we've modeled.
Is that the same one that's in the Runaway Bride as well?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they just do it up differently.
Yeah, they use a lot of
the thing
same
is,
sets.
Where in Cardiff is that corridor?
I'm trying to find it. Some warehouse somewhere.
Right, so.
That's why they.
Actually, never mind, a bit earlier. So, this piece of music here, this is finally time. This piece of music is called Martha's Quest. However, on Spotify, for some strange reason, it is simply called Martha's Quest.
Yeah,
and
Martha's.
I thought I was going nuts. And I thought, I swear to God it was called Martha's Quest.
Have they
Quest.
Not fixed it now?
Not on Spotify. But then I went back to my disc that I got in 2007, back in my parents' house, and it is also spelt incorrectly on the file. So I don't know what's going on. But for some reason on my file from 2007 and in Spotify, it is spelled as Martha's Quest. It is still there.
No one saw that.
Yeah. But currently on Apple Music, it is fine. On YouTube, it's fine. On Spotify, Martha's Quest.
Mm. It's just a kind of it's a big orange one from my grand day out. It's the
just all the rats in the bottom with the sunglasses on.
Yeah.
Oh. Why show?
Because he's to show that he's a future kind.
Showing the Nashers.
Yeah, because he's showing that he's a future kind.
I do not, for the audience, I do not agree. That is a perfectly understandable creative decision. There.
It's just a better way to do it.
What?
Don't do it in front of everyone.
Yeah, but like it's for the audience.
I think if it's just for the audience, I don't know if you can entirely forgive that. It's a big nitpick.
It's a big nitpick. Didn't ask.
Is there not a cutaway to the Christmas invasion in the Sound of Drums?
Might be.
There was a couple
because
of
it's so out of nowhere where he's explaining how he lost his hand.
Well, that's right there. There.
Yeah. Oh, was it?
Yeah,
did you just wipe the last 5 minutes?
It's just happened.
It's like 20 seconds.
Oh, there's no ear.
Memory of a goldfish. I that's why I was so confused. I was like, yeah.
Hi guys, I'm Louis.
I'm just moving.
What was that?
Another.
I always say that I'm a big fan of a camera that just moves. Like, see a stationary. Like, see, even there, there's just a little tiny zoom in. I'm like,
yeah.
Yes. If the camera's stationary,
love that wobble.
Yeah. If a camera's stationary, not acceptable. Quite frankly.
He's just thumbing
out
one
under
the table.
He's thumbing one under the table.
Oh yes. Just get doctor. Just looks around. He's got jizz in his coat. Oh my god.
Was it leaked beforehand that he was the master?
I don't know, actually.
I certainly didn't know. I just watched Spearhead from Space before this.
I don't think I knew the master was this.
Oh, I didn't know the master. I maintain this episode is maybe the most apeshit I've ever gone at a television before, because I could not believe it.
She was upset.
Yay!
No, I think the second and third time that they do
it. When they do it a third time, it's taking the piss a wee bit, but...
Just in case anyone's like blinked for like 30 seconds.
Well, let me
finish
this.
Wait, was that the future guy?
So there's a scene where Yana turns out to be the master in this episode.
Do you remember the number?
Come and see inside my...
I remember the Numberjacks. Numberjacks had the best crossover episode ever. See when all the villains came together and
won. Oh yeah!
Absolutely
Infinity War before Infinity War. the guy with the bubble beard and everything.
Yeah. Guys, this is insane!
Is it insane? See the shapeshifter?
Oh, you know, he was... Why was it so disturbing? Is that sort of like Flash animation, like Uncanny Valley?
Yeah, it's
like,
the one, you know?
And the, what was the number taker?
The number
taker.
It was number one though, he was terrifying. Beano.
Who was the pink one? Was it number two? The pink one was a baddie.
Smasher pass.
Smash.
Number two.
Wait, let's
see, whoever one was the pink one, fucking those curves were doing something different to 5-year-old me.
Number three was pink.
Number three.
Yeah, number three. Fucking baddie, by the way.
She was a baddie.
Number five is kind of cursed.
Zero
though.
As well.
No, zero's the most cursed.
No, I think one is cursed. Because one just looks like
was
a.
Was it not
woman.
That they were like based on.
They're based,
like,
yeah.
They were based.
It's not like they were
but
based as
number
fuck.
Zero not have like her like child voice, because it was like as they got on, it was like oldest.
Four was the leader.
Was four the leader?
Yeah, four was. Because he could put his little mobile in the.
But that's what I mean, like, go, I think like
five. They come inside the couch, don't they?
Five yeah. Above like weren't in it as much because they were like adults.
Yeah, they
and
were
the
old guys.
Younger,
number
yeah,
because it was
like
two and three used to always go out on the main missions.
Like in the Numberjacks lore.
Yeah, I can tell you
how do they
about
reproduce?
That.
See if two and four have sex, do they then make six?
Or do they make
is that
eight?
How it works?
Or is it a timesing thing?
Yeah,
or
is it a multiplication?
Or is it a division thing?
Is that how they, do they make one stick himself and say zero? And then is that child abuse?
That is, yeah, that's in, like.
Is it incest?
Is it incest? Yeah, because are they like a family?
What if, right, so yeah, so what if like the two and four give birth to like two six children, then the six children have incest sex, and then they make a 12?
Yeah, but you can't have two digits on their own, they'd have to combine.
No, but that's where incest is,
like,
because
so
all
like,
together.
Oh, yeah, so it's like Siamese twins,
oh,
fucking each other.
Jesus Christ. How did we get here?
Yeah! Like, that's such a weird way to think about maths now, that they're just fucking each other and that's you get them.
I think
we'll
do
David Mitchell logic of it. It's just a series of lines.
Oh,
and someone said those series of lines is a four. I don't accept that.
I think when a duplicate is created.
Zoom glasses.
I know, right?
I can heal you, yes!
Oh. I think when a duplicate is created in the Numberjacks, the original
they burn it. No, they burn it.
They
burn it so the Wicker Man, they all go around chanting.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Jesus Christ!
Oh God! Oh Jesus Christ!
Guy, yeah, if you're in Berlin, go see Monster Cabinet.
They're all go see Monster Cabinet.
No, go and see Monster Cabinet. It's fucking unreal.
No, it is. It's unreal.
Speak of Berlin, go see Cabaret in London.
No.
It's 1930s Germany.
Fucking hell.
How does
look
know?
At the pair of them. Oh, the cape's flapping.
How did you know someone was kissing?
I like
him?
How they that was such an unnecessary
but
result,
it was just cool.
But it just looks cool as fuck. So
is that not Russell T. Davis summed up in like a nutshell though?
Oh, he's so charismatic, but he's also a sex pest.
Yeah. Fuck him.
Oh, fuck. Man.
Idiot.
I know, it is such a pain in the ass to edit. I should start bringing the DVDs.
Yes.
Next. Just as we were getting to the absolute
starting next season, I'll bring the DVDs. For the last season, I'll bring the DVDs
if you want. I know exactly where they are.
I've got them in volumes.
As well. You've got the volumes. Yeah. I've got the box set, but... I always remember there was a very unfortunate video on YouTube titled 10 versus 9/11, and it wasn't actually about the September 11th attacks. It was about it was a fan edit of like the 10th Doctor turns evil and the 9th and 11th Doctors have to stop him.
Certain moments in time are fixed.
I made my choice.
Tiny, precious moment.
And I'm never gonna leave you.
There is no power on this earth that can stop me.
No, he's wrong.
What have you done?
Told you, you can't go back and change time.
That's for me to decide.
My entire planet, my whole family, do you think it never occurred to me to go back and save them?
Tough.
The whole universe is in danger if I let you.
This ends here.
And it's always, I remember this bit in particular because it was him looking through the red glass, you know, when he does like his evil looking grin, and it was Matt Smith in the Pandora cupboard.
I think I remember seeing
it. And he was like, no, don't do this. And it was David Tennant being like, I think like the plot of the fan edit was like David Tennant goes back to save Rose and like fucks up the universe, and the 9th and 11th Doctors have to stop him. Unfortunately, it was titled 10 versus 9/11.
Is it
9/11?
Oh god, that's so gross.
Have you ever come across any fan fiction in kind of the oeuvre of the Tumbling Towers that was its Doctor Who related? Because I've come across one and it was horrific.
What, the Doctor in 9/11?
The actual 9/11?
Yes. That's what fan films should be about, doing stuff that the movies can.
Yeah.
Not like Spider-Man Lotus, which is it's bad.
I'm waiting for Nerd Draw.
Spider-Man Lotus. Are you doing the worst watch is that?
I will actually kill myself.
I'm waiting for Nerd Drawtic to make Doctor Who Lotus, and it's like the answer to the Jodie Whittaker era of Doctor Who.
That's why it's good.
Do it. Do the thing. It's so
angry. You just went, do the thing, do the thing.
Dance monkey.
Yeah.
Television before. Unbelievable. I remember watching this with my dad and my sister. I'm going, absolutely crackers.
Mm. You see, sometimes I just shove on this scene to feel something.
To feel something, anything.
See, in the winter, deep in the depressive winter, I'm just like, just put this on. Just the last 10 minutes.
I like to light a match and let it burn in the
scene. Oh, wait, I'm pulling her up.
That's me.
That's building
fucked up, by the way.
What?
That he's been Yana since he was a child.
See, when that came up with the drums idea.
When that came back in World Enough in Time, when you see him, it was da 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 da.
This is it, when just there is no zero, it's all 11.
So
looking forward to the blue.
That's
blue
fucking Mission 2110.
That whole set could be Mission 2110.
Who's that?
Roger Delgado.
Oh, that's just.
Because that's the. So I remember this kicking off and I'd just seen that episode and I was like, oh my god.
I think the laugh might be Anthony Inley's one, I think.
That I remember.
Yeah, that wee Roger Delgado. Oh, that's just such a
thing. That and I was like.
Oh, I see that you are not alone.
Ah! It was that there. I remember being like. Up at
like
the
100 trillion years in the future, they've got wee blue folders sitting on
the table. It was this year, I remember being up at the television screen like this, just.
Oh, it's a swim here! Oh!
That's shot.
Is that
sound
effect
that
this
was
is
in
the
water?
Yeah, in the water.
It's this
year.
It's
this
year.
You are not alone.
Yeah.
The music. This is also like just the scenes playing and they're just skins coming off the terror. Just like,
this is unreleased music as well. It should, they should release this.
Is it? Is it unreleased?
Like this scene. I've just realised watching this for the first time is like that scene, you know, the bit with the hyperdrive hits and wallies and just
it's the Neil deGrasse Tyson though. It's the way he's a Derek Jacobi for the like 2 minutes that he plays the master, he is just
peak. Yeah.
He just switches from that old nice professor to evil in an instant.
I think
he's
it's
such
the
a great actor.
I think it's the drums with They should have done it like him for like half of the next
he should have regenerated halfway through, I think. Have that be the cliffhanger at the end of the next one.
He's so short.
So just maybe a four part.
So suddenly there's a new person.
And then have John Simby. Yeah, could you imagine, like, because that would be cool, like, the Prime Minister dies and then comes back up as John Sim. Everyone's like, what the
this is brilliant.
Ooh. Now I can say I was provoked. He does that Roger Delgado thing so well, where it's like, he's very polite and, like, but if you turn your back, he would kill you. Yeah.
I love the insanity of John Sim that's been done too many times.
It's too Joker-y for me. In
I like John
few.
Sim.
Seeing World Enough in Time, he's fantastic, yeah. But I think in this one he's a bit too Joker-y, which is interesting because it was before Dark Knight, but it feels very inspired.
I think he's too Joker-y
in the Time.
In the Time, yeah.
Here I can forgive it because it was the first time.
Yeah. And it was something different at least, because all the Masters had been more like this.
Sacha Dhawan, I think, is as much as he is.
I like
good,
how angry he is all the time.
Yeah,
just,
but I think he's just always at 11. There's
yeah,
never like a,
there's never. I want like a calmer, like more,
yeah,
like cerebral master again.
Oh
yeah. Yeah, to this day the most ape shit I've ever got on television. I honestly was like.
But the thing is, for people that haven't ever
yeah,
seen Classic Who, they do a good job in the next
yeah,
episode of explaining like who he is.
They do a good
no,
job at least
so
just making the cliffhanger good.
I will
well.
See what I will say, yeah, I'll say this.
Because new fans wouldn't have experienced that evil time
I'll
before.
Say, if they were to write it again, I'd say, yeah, keep, should have kept Derek Jackery for one more episode, like.
Yeah.
Like,
at least
that was
one
a great
more.
Shot. Oh, filmmaking.
Oh my god.
You're just coming over the
Utopia.
Song.
Is that filmmaking?
Utopia.
Oh, that's so fucked up. So
like this cliffhanger has layers.
Yeah.
You're like, where the hell have
it's
people
so
gone?
It's so dense. Every image has so much going on in it.
It's so dense. Every single image has so many things going on.
Well, that kind of sounds like Obi-Wan Kenobi's death sound.
I love
that.
Yeah, that's because he's now a Time Lord. He instantly recognizes who he is.
They've
there.
Never done
like,
that again,
shit. I know, and I hate it. Because, like, I like the fact that...
That key would have worked.
Time Lords always.
I promise you, we do.
Time
Lords. That's happened before with that door, and I'm like, shit.
Time Lords always recognise each other no matter what regeneration they're in. So I like how he didn't recognise him as the professor, but now that he's got the master back in him, he has that look and he's like, oh shit, I know who it is. I like that his regeneration seems like
white.
Painful.
It's also green?
Yeah.
Reborn. I'm so
he probably screams when he
yeah.
goes
like
generic.
It's green and it's wild, but that is a
that's
terrible green screen. Why is his
yeah.
mouth
it
look,
is.
Why does his mouth look like it's separate from the rest of his face?
Or because
yeah,
it was,
yeah.
because they were rotoscoping the two faces onto it.
Like, it doesn't look as
it's so good.
It kind of works.
That, I know that this voice, that voice as well.
Yeah.
I know that voice. It's got layers.
It does.
It's like an onion.
Layers.
It's so dense, every single image has so many things going on.
The problem is, I can't watch this scene without Ryan's YDP in my head of the bit where he just goes,
hi! Hi! Did you have the...
He looks weird in this outfit, though.
No. Yeah, he needs to be in a suit.
Did you guys ever have the, like, top the fin thing that you've got, like, the sonic screwdriver and the laser
yeah,
and you had to, like,
yeah,
battle
yeah.
it? That was so fucking cool.
He's so good.
He is excellent. This was during Life on Mars as well, so he was a big name at this point.
Hold on, I know that voice. It's Sam Tyler from Life on Mars.
That's one of the few times he's ever used the
extender.
Yeah, Matt Smith used it though, like with it.
It's so funny.
It's so good.
I remember. I love how this cliffhanger lets you feel like how the fuck
are they getting out of this?
Is it the second most aim shit I've ever got? Was probably when I heard the sound and I was like, no.
No matter how many times you watch that,
it just gets better and better every single time. I think it's the music.
It's that Graham Harper, there's no zero. Yeah. It's just 11.
The music, the acting.
Jacoby's credited as Yana and Johnson as the master, interestingly. Yeah, that was great.
You're schnunkered.
God damn,
yeah.
Utopia, what do we think? I just need to say it.
Loved it.
So, guys, we're watching Utopia then.
So, guys, are we not watching Utopia today?
Yeah, I thought that's what we
The thing is, I remember the next time has been fantastic as well.
I don't remember the next
time.
There
was a next time. Because it ends with
The next time for Last of Time Lords is the best next time trailer of the whole.
Well, I don't know about that one. Turn left.
That's a good one, but Last of Time
Lords. This is great.
I don't remember.
It's a little shine in his teeth.
Yeah, they
really good.
Oh, my friends. Got a fun fact about the top of fame for next time. This was the template for years and years.
I've just noticed they've not shown the Dr. Martha.
No.
Right
there.
Is it Doctor? Bing. Yeah, no Dr. Martha. It's Peak.
Wait, Derek Jacoby was the master?
Wait, what?
In an ordinary sofa, in an ordinary room, extraordinary heroes who are standing by to see.